Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another episode of CSGO News. Hope you guys all enjoyed today's episode. Please leave a comment down below what your favorite story is today. All of today's stories will also be time marked in the description. As always, let's hop into our first story, though, and I'm sure you guys saw the thumbnail on this one. A big story out there is how to play CSGO with the PUBG viewer model, which more famously or previously was known as the third-person viewer model, but throughout 2017, with PUBG's popularity, has slowly become the PUBG viewer model. I'm going to show you guys today the three quick commands you actually have to enable to actually play in the PUBG view model inside the game of CSGO. Now, first off, I do want to clarify, you can't do this on public matchmaking servers or deathmatch or casual servers. You can only do it on your own as of right now, or any online servers that actually allow cheats to be activated. So the quick three commands you guys need to know, I'll post them on screen and also show you the gameplay of me doing this myself. Very quickly, guys, of course, SV cheats, one, to turn on the cheats. This is why it's not allowed in public matchmaking or any public servers at all as of right now, because Valve has to add this as a game mode for that to be worth it. Also, the second command is cam underscore command one. And very lastly, C underscore third person shoulder one. That's those three commands, and as you guys can see on screen as well, it gets pretty fun for about 30 seconds, and then of course, it not being a game mode, you can only do this by yourself or against bots, it tends to be unfun very, very fast. But this actually was in response to Taco's tweet. Taco had this tweet on screen a few days ago, actually at the CSGO dev, saying, hey, here's a good game mode for this, and I actually partially agree with this. I want to know what you guys think about this. Would a third person shooter game mode actually be good for CSGO? Would you guys enjoy it? And my first thought was, okay, we're going to try and kind of stretch away from the current game mode of CSGO, and would this actually be a great viewership experience? Would this be an actual great game mode for the game itself? My main worry was, of course, if we start going that way away from the first-person shooter era, that's where I get a bit worried, and of course, I would never want this game mode to be an actual competitive game mode down the line. In terms of viewership experience, I think we've seen the growth of PUBG viewership-wise on streams, but then when it comes to their tournaments, they're really not fun to watch, so I hope it doesn't develop into that kind of game mode where eventually the pro players for CSGO are playing third-person shooter, and it just goes all the way away from FPS. So hope you guys all enjoyed that, and if you guys want to play CSGO like PUBG for the time being, it's not too fun, but maybe in the future it will be a game mode. And also in CSGO news, this next story is going to get this video demonetized. I've had stories in the past, of course, that have gotten demonetized. You know, a lot of my videos actually have been. I just haven't talked about it a lot. This next story will certainly be demonetized my video, because we're going to be talking about a terrorist and a terrorist group known as Al-Qaeda. Of course, their former leader, Osama bin Laden, was assassinated by U.S. soldiers a long time ago, and this next story actually surfaced a little bit ago because, if you guys are not aware of the U.S. politics going on in place the past few weeks, we actually had those documents from 9/11, of course, the terrorist attack led by Al-Qaeda, led by Osama bin Laden before he was assassinated later on. He was actually a participant in that terrorist attack, one of the worst, if not the worst, in American history. Of course, very well known for that, so I don't want to talk about it too much. We actually had all those documents of purloining around that event actually released a couple weeks ago based on one of Trump's new actions put in place. All those documents were released around Al-Qaeda, around Osama himself, and in those documents actually pervade his favorite video games. I know they actually had so much background information about this guy. It went down to the great detail of the video games he played, and it just so happened in those documents, I'll show you guys screenshots or a video on screen right now, and one of those games he did play was indeed Counter-Strike. Now, I know we've had in the past, we've talked about other armies out there, other military groups from other countries actually using CSGO as a training technique. I'm not sure if Al-Qaeda used that themselves, or he just enjoyed the game itself. In the article, it actually talks about, of course, this having a counter-terrorist and a terrorist group in the game of CSGO itself. Maybe that's why he enjoyed the aspect of the game. But yes, Osama bin Laden, one of the most infamous terrorists of all time, did indeed play Counter-Strike. Think about what you guys want. Of course, what he did was incredibly wrong, and I never would want to actually draw attention to that. But it was kind of interesting to see that he did actually play Counter-Strike Global Offensive. And because this video is probably demonetized by now, I'm so thankful for you guys watching, as well as the sponsors who keep on offering me small sponsorship offers. This one being skins.cash. So I know a lot of you guys are probably selling skins right now, either on OP Skins, other websites out there, and I can tell you right now, skins.cash is also a great website to instantly sell your skins for cash, whether PayPal payment, other forms of payment as well. If you guys want to use their link, I'll link it down below in the description for all of you guys who are selling your skins right now before any big panic in the market. As of right now, the market is pretty high in CSGO, so if any of you guys are thinking about selling your skins sometime soon and need that cash very, very fast, or want some great bonuses, I know skins.cash, the more you sell with them, the more you make. So their link will be down below, guys. If you want to check it out, just click on it, check out their website as well. Hope you guys all enjoy, and huge thanks to skins.cash for sponsoring this video. I really do appreciate that, because ad revenue, well, it's not there. But also in huge news for all you Optic fans out there, we've had a lot going on in the Optic organization. Of course, we had news last week that Hector, their former owner, sold a majority ownership spot to a Texas Ranger investor. That was actually Neil Libman, or Neil, I probably mispronounced his name, a big investor over there. We have bigger changes, though, as according to I'm a Pet, their coach for Optic Gaming CSGO team, he's actually changed some roles. This actually returns Mixwell to a full-time opper, and their former opper, that was Al Liu, of course, formerly of FaZe Clan, has a lot of big fan following him. He's actually returning to a rifle role. Now, this actually feeds the rumors out there that have been starting to bust themselves. The rumor right now is that Dennis, of course, formerly of Godsent, he was actually released to their bench. He might be bought out by some team out there, which actually might be Optic. Optic had an interest in him a long time ago when he was formerly a Fnatic. That offer did fall through. So it does seem as of right now, with Optic going back to Europe, back to their home of Europe after ESL Pro League does conclude, it does seem possible they might buy him out and maybe replace him for an Alu or even a Freiburg. I know a lot of people out there are saying, you know, each individual player of Optic has their own great role in that team and the team does not need changes. I would not disagree with that, okay? I'm not saying that Optic needs changes, but it's certainly possible he could replace an Alu. Alu obviously can rifle, but he's certainly not your best rifler. He's meant to be an Opper as well. This also maybe could do with Freiburg as well. If we move Freiburg to rifle role and take him off the IGL, Dennis has also formerly in the past been an IGL role as well. We'll see what happens in the future, guys. Does Optic necessarily need changes at this time? Certainly not, but it definitely could happen. And another very sad news for all you Virtus Pro fans out there, we continue to talk about the Virtus Pro struggles, this being the ESL Pro League curse. Of course, we have next season, season 7 of ESL Pro League, and Virtus Pro, yet again for the second time, will not be in ESL Pro League, guys, yet, despite being one of the better teams, and of course, in Europe. But when it comes to online play, we all know they do struggle, and this actually continued this year throughout ESL Premier. They did quite well throughout the tournament itself, but after back-to-back losses to Team AGO, AGO is a team who has now beat Virtus Pro in best of threes multiple times in the past month alone. After losing to Team AGO first off, and then Space Soldiers in the last chance qualifier there as well, they lost to Space Soldiers also in a best of three. They have now lost their spot or chance at ESL Pro League Season 7, and they will now be back down to Premier for the second season in a row. But even bigger news for Team AGO and Space Soldiers, AGO will face off against Exodus. The winner of that group will actually nail their and solidify their spot in Season 7 of Pro League. The loser of AGO and Exodus will actually face off. They're actually going to have a spot in relegation matches with Space Soldiers. So to give you guys a little screenshot on screen as well, we have Space Soldiers and the loser of AGO and Exodus. They will actually face off against the two lowest teams currently in EU ESL Pro League, and that those four teams will compete for the last two spots of next season for Pro League. So Space Soldiers and the loser of AGO and Exodus have a great shot at actually making ESL Pro League next season, and then the winner of AGO and Exodus actually solidify their spot. They actually get a guaranteed spot. So a lot of big changes happening here in the European scene. It almost makes you kind of glad that Virtus Pro is losing. If they don't deserve it, it opens a spot for a brand new team out there to join Pro League and see how they actually can do. The only problem is, with European ESL Pro League all being so close, the last two spots or the last two places who actually compete for the relegation matches are likely to be very, very good European teams who will face off against Space Soldiers and the loser of AGO and Exodus. They're gonna have their hands full with whoever who they play against to actually get those spots in ESL Pro League. Oh, and very quickly, I do want to say, many of you guys know I am back at home. My sister should be back home sometime in the next 4 to 5 days, so please do me a favor on my next few videos, leave a question down below in the comment section, whatever you guys want to ask me and my sister. We're gonna do a live Q&A like we did way, way back in the day. If you guys remember, like 2 years ago, we did a Q&A. This is my twin sister, Jenny, so ask whatever questions you guys want. Keep them like not inappropriate, but I mean, I really don't care too much. Comment them down below and I'll pick out the best ones. So thank you guys for doing that. And now to my outro, and plug your ears, it's gonna be loud. As always, that's gonna do it for today's episode of CSK News. Hope you guys all enjoy. I don't know what it is, being back at home makes me feel so open. I can just talk so openly. So hope you guys did enjoy, and thank you guys for the support on yesterday's video. I know a lot of you guys did hate that video, but I do understand. But I hope you guys understand I have to pay the bills here, and sometimes I have to make a video that's just a sponsored video, and it wasn't a fully gambling video. So thank you guys who actually understood that. I will be doing one 15-second pre-roll ad with that website, PV Pro, I think next video or the video after that. Just a 15-second ad or sponsorship that was part of the agreement, not another dedicated video. So thank you guys who actually enjoyed that and really understood I have to pay the bills around here. So seriously, I cannot thank you guys enough. Please leave a comment down below. I'm going to be replying to comments all day today because I have nothing else to do. So as always, my name is Jake Murmur, I like you, and let's do a yelling outro. So if you guys don't like yelling outros, just click away now. But my name is Jake, I like bye. Goodbye!